Hey everyone, I want to do a year two on our landscaping and just kind of do an update. I'm going to try to go fast. The first video wasn't very good, so I'm going to try to go over this, and then it's just a good reminder for me so I can see what I was going to do and what I did do. So here's where the grapes are going to go. I'm pretty sure it's going to be Grenache and Syrah. What we've been doing is just pulling the weeds, all the ivy, getting some of the charcoal retilled back into the soil. It's an ancient way to retain moisture in your soil. It's very good practice. Get rid of some of the laurel. Kill, keep most of it. It's a good hedge, but it's got to get managed. We're finding some natives popping up. Here's a vine maple. Again, the beaver. Beaver did his job to that one. There's a holly coming up here. We have a beautiful, several beautiful large locusts, black locusts, and these are just great. They're nitrogen fixing. They attract pollinators like nothing. I mean, it sounds like a concert out here with the bees buzzing when it's in full bloom, so that's going to be great. The plums that I was managed to salvage, took out of them tied up now, finally. Just trying to straighten them up before I cut them. Cut them back down again. Anyway, got this mulched out. This is a good... I can do about a half a day of pulling ivy before it's over with. So this is about 2 or 3 days worth of half days. Once you get rid of that ivy, though, and the knotweed, we're getting rid of all the knotweed. So the little shoots, when they first come up, they are edible. They are delicious. They have a citrusy flavor with a little bit of a crunch. It's kind of a citrus asparagus. So we've been sauteing those up in Earth Balance, and we've been loving it. So everybody in Washington, eat knotweed sprouts. They're non-native, invasive, and they choke out everything. And please don't plant ivy, ever. So these are little saplings that we managed to salvage. This is just a locust, so it's great. It works great with the fruit trees, brings in pollinators, helps fix some nitrogen, gives us some nice, and the wood is on par with ipe as far as exterior use and architecture, design, deckings, anything like that. So I'll show you some projects that are going on with that. I managed to salvage some storm damage stuff. Up here on this side, we're just doing the roadies. Got it all cleaned out, all the ivy's gone, so this is just cool for the birds and the rabbits like it and stuff. The other video, I mentioned we were going to do terracing. So this is the first terrace of the blueberries. There'll be two more. And then there'll be a meandering path up to the door. This is where we spend the most of our time, so this is our fall color. I'm bringing in the blueberries. I have a mix of Polaris and Duke, maybe? I forget. I'd have to go back and look. But in front, and then all the foxgloves are still in blossom. And it's October, so that's pretty cool. The rhubarb's finally coming back. We let it go to seed, so it really went back down. But we'll bring it back. And we'll bookend this bed with the rhubarb, and then we'll bring that all the way down, all three terraces. We'll do blueberries, bookend with rhubarb, probably interplant with some strawberries, and just we'll make those a pie. And then we'll bring our wildflowers in here. Box raised bed gardens are in. They're all new soil, so we're working on it. Anyway. We're just letting this go. This is going to be winter greens now, and everything that's coming up now has just been in here for a while. Some Brussels sprouts, peppers, Russian kale, whatever. And this year, I'm not pulling anything out. I am just interseeding. So we have collards, corn salad, kale, spinach, stuff like that. Trees that the beaver took down last year. Starting to come back. We're getting some leaf eaters, but I'm getting some good spiders, some predators. Sorry, buddy. Anyway, so I'm gonna nurture these back. last remaining little bits of the eggplants. Just pulled out all the squash, so this is all onion bulbs now. So we'll just let those go to spring. Get some great. Oh, look, there's one more. Yes. Look at that. One more. Last one. All these eggplants are delicious. They're the little Japanese ichiban. This compost is. This is the system's going away. This is a pain in the butt, and it's going. So I've got a new design coming up for a different project, and just leftovers in here as well. I tried to do okra just because we love okra, but nothing doing. Freaky season this year. Cold snap real early, real hot, then a real early cold snap, and then a real big heat wave. So everything just went bonkers, and everything bolted on me. So my first whole planting's bolted. It was a total waste of cauliflower and broccoli. So the blue Tuscans are coming in great. Bookend as well. Mary Washington asparagus. Might actually get some this year. Really stoked about that. Or next year. Let it go to seed. The sage is really coming in, and we cook with this daily. Chives. This bed is going to just be pretty much bulbs, and the wife has dahlias, gladioli, tulips, hyacinths, daffodils. There's all kinds of stuff in here. The fig. We had one fig. It was delicious. But I'm going to get that planted once I get this dead hemlock out of here. The ivy choked it out and killed it, and the big leaf maple just wrapped around it so it doesn't get any light. Anyway, these are actually raspberries up here. So the wife kind of takes care of this section, and she did a lot of work up here. So cold frame, that's going. It's too small anyway, but this is just our little shady part. This is the hospital. Saving some lilacs because the leaf cutter bees really like it. And if you want to check out that other video of me letting loose, 100 or so leaf cutter bees, that was really cool. So they like to use the leaves to wrap their larvae in and plug the holes. So we want to put that around the garden so that they have material. Some hemlock to go up on the hill. I salvaged all these cuttings. See the rose hips. And I'm just trying to root these. This is the, from the first video, this is the native blueberry. This is Vaccinium ovatum. And it's a delicious little berry. It's absolutely, the bears go nuts over it. You pretty much find their bellies full of them. And then, yeah, I just love them too. So they're evergreen. They provide a great hedge. Delicious. So two things, I'm rooting these ones in water. I have some in the house in water as well. We'll see how that does. It just has rooting hormone and water, and this is like a Dutch oven concept where, I think it's a Dutch oven, Dutch pot, I don't know. Anyway, it's soil, soil mixed in there with some sandy, substrate, and then it's just a pot just dunked in a big old bucket of water. Just keep the level so that it's swampy, and we'll see how that works. I just got some shade plants trying to keep this little shade. It's a turtle head. Some stuff that we find, when you go through the compost and you find avocados growing, so we put them in there. Some lupines I'm trying to save. Oh, I forgot about these. I've saved these. These almost died on me, so I'm gonna get my artichokes back into the landscape here. They had to come up here for rescue. I'm trying to save some chestnut. I want to plant some chestnut, but save these from a ditch. It was getting redone. We just redid the house, so it's nice bright yellow. So the reason this is the hospital is because the potting table's over here, and also our rain barrel, so everything that gets scorched in the sun comes back here for resuscitation. St. John's wort, I have three of these in the ground now, so I'm just determining where to put this one. Try to mix it up a little bit more. Little Japanese maples, those will go in there somewhere, but check out what the wife found. She'd been over here for about, 4 weekends, and I couldn't figure out what she was doing. And she found this little household staircase. And she dug out the old rocks. This was kind of fun, and there's like a little waterfall, and there was this little fountain. You can see someone had like a little fountain, and there was some lighting and like some maybe some old plumbing, but we already get enough water, so we're not gonna do that. Anyway, this is kind of the shady spot, so this is gonna be a lot different, but hopefully we'll get to do some cool stuff in there. Sorry, I got Fearless Scottish Ale from the Oregon Rivers. It's just a beautiful day. Up here it's just decorative. These are all existing. It's a giant camellia, but this is strawberry. I think there's some decoratives in there, and then raspberries, delicious. Have some more herbs over there in the rose garden. Then here's the big terrace project that we've been doing. Got all the 4x4s free off of Craigslist. Went down to the port, and you know they get machinery in there all the time on these huge pallets, and he just loaded me up as much as I could take. They thought I was crazy, but what can you do? So anyway, we added more blueberry. Here's our awesome blueberry bush bringing us some color. If you remember, this is the one with all the Nuka rose in it, giving it this nice protective structure underneath. So here we have some, let's see, blue gold, northern high bush. This whole area, I'm going to come back and do 1, 2, 3, 4, probably 6 more. So there'll be 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 10, big one, 12, just on this side. So we love blueberries, and we make a really mean blueberry mead. So it's what I've been doing with the logs that we had up there, and then I just come back and bury them in the mulch. So here's a little, not the best one, but here's an example of what I'm doing in between the fruit trees. On each terrace is there's going to be foxglove, and there's also lupine. There's also columbines, and there's two more. This one doesn't look like it survived, but it was a larkspur. Shoot, I can't believe it died. Anyway, so then we have some ceanothus. This is a nitrogen fixer, evergreen, also a great pollinator attractor. So we kind of mix that in a little bit. Protection, I showed on that last video, to try to stop the beaver. Didn't stop the deer, but did stop the beaver. Then each bed on the back side, try to get the shadow behind me here. So on the front side, we'll have the blossom, beautiful flowers. Most of them are all purple as well. So that was kind of something I did intentionally. I want this side to be all purple. I think you get a better attractant of honeybees and mason bees, but we'll see. Might just be my theory. Anyway, so each corner gets rosemary, lavender, valerian root, and we harvest the valerian root and the flowers. Same with the rosemary and the lavender. And then I'm going to add yarrow is going to go right here. So future plant, that's saved for the yarrow, another blueberry. And then again, so each one is the same. There's ceanothus, blueberry, there'll be yarrow, valerian, lavender, and rosemary. And these kind of give me the scent masking that I'm looking for to try to hope I can fake the beaver out. See them in my mason bee house and my leafcutter bee house. That's a different video, but that should be very helpful for the orchard. Really hoping to get more bees, and there should be a bee box down here by the end of spring. And each in the center is a goji berry. What is that? Lycium. So that's a nitrogen fixer. It's also one of the best fruits for health purposes in the world. But beaver took two on me last year, so. So that kind of gives you an idea. Each terrace gets 3 fruit trees, pollinator attractors, scent masking herbs, a goji berry, a ceanothus to assist with pollinator attracting, and nitrogen fixing. So hopefully this will also help reduce the soil runoff as it comes down this hill, and hopefully we'll get a little bit more retention. Also behind each one of these, in between the rosemary and the sage, and actually it's a square all the way around them. These are actually kind of like in the hugel culture kind of scenario, and you'll actually see, this is, wow, it's already turning to dirt. Anyway, they have logs surrounding them, and then I fill them in so that that's protected, so I can line trim around them, and then I'll come back when I get mulch and bury them. So you can see, I mean, I put, this is almost 10 inches of mulch, 6 inches of mulch, easy. Trying to kill that ivy. So in between all the plants are logs that are helping just retain that moisture and also produce some mycelium. Some of my nurse logs for the mushroom garden failed, so I just buried them in here. Hey, something might happen, right? Alright, so then it goes apple. I tried to do them in order of blossoming. And then, so it's apple, pear, cherry, plum. And then up here it gets a little bit longer, so this is going to kind of get doubled up without the terrace. But the planting will still be the same. And then in here you see, don't get rid of these guys. They are very helpful. Yep, won't mess with you. See, this goji berry is very happy. And then also I'll do like pumpkins and squashes in here. This was a pumpkin. A lot of it just died because I didn't have this mulch in. So again, ceanothus, plums. I just walked right through them. Sorry, buddy. Just said I wasn't going to mess with them, and I messed with them, but saved it. Okay. So we also do like tomatoes in here. It just helps for the watering. Just water everything, you know. Then up here, right. So here we got some other things is on the ends. Peonies, gladioli. We're just trying to mix it all up and just keep it going. This is the one that's in the middle, so you kind of get an idea of the log plantings that I'm talking about. This is the newest one, so they're pretty small still. And then same thing, goji berry. This is the apricot. We added apricot this year. Got a goji berry. And then this is persimmon that we added this year. And then these are cascade hops we just harvested. This is their first year. So I did them in pots, and they're going to go in the ground. And we know where they want to go. And we just got to build the arbor. What else? Japanese maples. I put the more mushroom inoculated logs here. We're doing a weir, trying to retain some of the sediment runoff so that it doesn't go all the way down. Try to keep some of our stuff. We also added gooseberries, flowering red currant, black currant, and another red currant. Also, a cool thing is we added sweet bay. I love cooking with bay, so whenever I make stews and chilies, bay goes in it. So all I have to do is come out here now and just pick a couple, or just grab some from the kitchen if they're dried. But the fresh ones are really sweet on the bay leaves. This is the red plum. I took it down, tried to get the color a little bit lower, and the fruit was too high to harvest, so hopefully this will be a little bit better. Cut a little trail up here. And this is what's been taking all of our time. See, this is all ivy. You can see ceanothus, but this is all ivy, so it took me probably 4 days, like 8-hour days, to get all the ivy out of here. It was very entrenched, killed a lot of trees. So this is more native, kind of green privacy fence, but this is what's been taking all my time. This is the well house, and I haven't quite finished putting together the video for this, but this is the well, and that's the well house, so kind of the shop. Anyway, these are the hand-hewn planed timbers from the timber felling video, and whatever videos else I put up about this. So anyway, that brings us to this cool part that is definitely changing as well. So this is the next big spot that doesn't have any design implementation. I have an idea, but I don't have any concrete plans. But right now we're just trying to get some plants to take hold and retain the soil because of the ivy. There's the steps that we found. So I'm slowly getting those mortared in temporarily until we redo the hardscaping. But right now I want to get some roadies. Right now I want to get this all. This is going to get mulched, planted out. This will be partial sun, partial shade kind of plants. And then you can see we had to, again, till in some char wood. Oops. Then we're going to come up here. That's a vine maple. Try to do a native border here. A lot of storm damage up here. But see, starting to bring the mulch down. Cover all this up and get it ready for winter. There's the first video, we had that little well. And then behind it, I found a nice little rockery. So I'll put a really cool bench in there. And we went ahead and went up. This is where the war was on the ivy. This is where all the debris was. So this is kind of my work space up here now with the chipper. Everything's almost chipped up. Firewood's even going down. This is that's locust. It does not rot. So it's becoming a bench. I have one in the works, and then here's another cool one that's half split. That one is also going to be in the works. I have a design for that as well. And then between, we're coming with the evergreen huckleberries. So in between each cedar will be evergreen huckleberry. They marry up well. They're native with the western red cedars. They do great in the acidic soil. They do well in sun, they do well in shade, so it just works. We'll do some same thing up here. This will be probably evergreen huckleberry as well. If not, maybe some kind of partial shade blueberry. I don't know if that's going to work. So this will all get mulched in. This will be a retaining wall. Here's a look at how that other retaining wall came out with all the inner stackings. Oh, spiderweb. So, it's a lot of the locust in there, so it won't decay. But I'm just stacking that up, let it rot, cover it up. I'm going to plant on top of it. Red huckleberry does very well on top of these dead stands like this, but it's great for the animals. Squirrels have a place to hide. Chipmunks. Don't know what happened to the rabbits. Hunting season started and the rabbits disappeared. So still clearing out that. And this is locust. So I'll be milling that. That's probably going to go in the shed pretty soon here. So getting there. I thought about doing truffle blueberry or truffle inoculated hazelnuts because we have a lot of hazelnuts, but I think we're going to scrap that and do ginseng. So we're trying to retain some of the wall and just get a little bit of this back. So anyway, that's the terrace and the garden, herbs. This will be a little bit different back here, and this is the forest. Call this the mail trail. So trying to retain the soil here, try to keep the mountain up on the mountain and not on the front step. So these are already starting to show some mycelium, and we even had some right here in my little palisade. And here's where all the mulch is coming from. So you can see why it takes so long to mulch a bed. Anyway, hope y'all are replanting with some intelligent ideas and not just making the lawn green and not wasting your space. So grow some food, if not for you, for the animals, or just think about the soil and try to plant something that's native so that we don't get these crazy invasive species that try to take everything down. Leave something for the next generation, right? It's the best we can do. So hopefully year three we'll have some more nut trees and I will be able to show some harvest this time of year. Fruit trees take a little while and everything else is just getting back to building up the soil, getting rid of the invasive species. So anybody got any ideas, please comment, let me know. I get my ideas from a lot of folks out there, so you know, there's a lot of good blogs, so check them out. You get some permies.com, Plant Abundance, gosh, I'm on a whole bunch of subscriptions that folks that give me these ideas like making these damn videos, but it helped because I forgot last year. Imagine that. But anyway, so happy trails.